Once again, I want to say happy Sabbath to you all. Today is a special day in the life of Babcock University. And we want to rejoice with our graduates and their parents this morning. My task is to do introductions. I'm human. And therefore, if I do not recognize you, what is most important is that heaven recognizes you. This morning, I will not want to take your time because what is most important should be given sufficient time. And therefore, I will first of all want to welcome here our Almighty God who has led us through this school year. So many things transpired in the course of the school year, the outbreak of Lassa fever, and so many other things, the change of administration, but through it all, God has been faithful. To him be glory forever. I will want to start the introduction by introducing our proprietors. And we have our regional headquarters in Abidjan, Cote d'Ivoire. We have here with us today the Executive Secretary of the West Central Africa Division, and that is the person of Pastor Dr. Kingsley Ananaba. Could you stand? Also a graduating parent and the wife. Please, madam, could you rise for recognition? Thank you very much. The daughter is graduating in the School of Law. Next to him is the one who take care of our finances in the 22 countries. And that is the West Central African Division Treasurer, Elder Emmanuel Manu Akwaba. We also have with us the son of the soil, who happens to be one time the, what you call today, the Deputy Vice Chancellor of during the ASUA days. And he has been our Education Director in West Central African Division for close to 20 years. I want to thank God for his faithful service to the church. I have here Professor Chiemela Ikone and a beautiful wife. In the audience also, we have the Associate Treasurer for our division in person of Elder Afolaya and the wife. Could you stand for recognition? I now move to the Governing Council members. I may not be able to mention your name one after the other because of time. I want you to rise for recognition. They've been wonderful. Please, could you rise for recognition? Thank you very much. Also, we have here the past Governing Council members. I remember was ably led by Uncle Joe at one time, Pastor Dr. Joseph Ola. I could see also Professor Friday Mbon, a former Deputy Vice Chancellor of the University of Calabar, also a member of the Governing Council, the past Governing Council. And now I move to our union conferences. And I want to start with the Eastern Nigerian Union Conference, who also doubles as the pro-chancellor for Babcock University in person of Pastor Dr. Percy Udo. We want all those that are coming from Eastern Nigerian Union Conference to rise for recognition. Eastern Nigerian Union Conference, if you are in the audience, please could you rise? Our church leaders, presidents, and officers, and directors, thank you very much. I moved to the north, but I'm not going to mention the president because I will have time to introduce him in a very special way. But all our guests from the Northern Nigerian Union Conference that are in the audience, please could you rise for recognition? They will. Sonuku. And now I move to where we are today. The Western Nigerian Union Conference, ably led by Pastor Dr. Oyeleke Alabi Owolabi, and all the guests, officers, presidents from this union conference, rise for recognition. I also have here someone all the way from the Cameroon. These fellows worked with me when I was serving at our university there as a member of the governing council, the then treasurer of the Central African Union Mission, in person of Elder Wogu, also a graduating parent. Bon arrivé. Now I move to institutions. We have here two of our friends representing the Adventist University of Africa, all the way from Kenya. Could you rise for recognition? Dr. Onunga Kempin and Dr. Techi. We move on to Valley View University in Ghana. They have a very large contingent of about 4 delegates gracing this occasion. Kindly rise for recognition. We also have the president or the vice chancellor of Caleb University and the wife in the audience. Sorry, did I know? We are honored to have in this graduation ceremony the vice chancellor elect of our own proposed Clifford University, Aba Abia State. Professor Chimena Oswe Umar and the wife. Chimeze, forgive me. Not Chimela, Chimeze as well. Omiyonu. About 3 days ago, the memorandum of understanding we had with a university in the United States, God blessed that relationship as 8 guests walked into my office from Savannah University, Georgia, in the USA. Are they in the audience this morning? They came with a mouth-watering gift to the university. I want to thank God for that relationship. They are not here today. And now, as a royal, as a member of the royal family, I cannot but remember and thank in a very special way our KBC, your loving of vision. To say this, Kabiezi has not only been my father, but a very good friend. Almost every now and then, I'm in the palace.
And he's always coming to pay me visit from time to time. We have the AUA students here on campus for the summer program. They are church leaders all over this division. If you are in the audience, could you rise for recognition? Thank you very much. Now we have our parents and guardians. I'm sure some of them are here. If you are parents, could we see you? Raise up your hands. Thank you very much. God bless you. This morning, I want to specially thank the officers that have been working with me in the last 6 months. I've enjoyed tremendous cooperation. I remember when we were building the 450-seater lecture theater at the Peru campus, which was commissioned yesterday. We were literally having meetings in that place. I remember for this graduation, some of them goes to bed at 11 p.m. What a wonderful set of team members. I want to play a glowing tribute to Professor Iha Uchukwu Okoro, the Senior Vice President, and the wife. Thank you very much. The Lord bless you. Also in the team, I have the Senior Vice President, the Deputy Vice Chancellor of Management Services, Professor Sunday Ajayi Olami, and the wife. Thank you very much for the good job. The Vice President for Financial Affairs is a very meticulous. No cobble can pass him by without finding out how and why. Thank you very much for keeping the good posts. The Lord will bless you abundantly. Elder Folonso Akane and the wife. Thank you. The prayer warrior for the team is the Vice President for Student Development, Pastor Dr. Joseph Olariwa and the wife. I also have the associate officers here and the deans. I remember when we were at the Senate, we had to go back and forth to be sure that we do not leave any name, because that can be very, very disastrous. I want to thank you very much for burning the candles at both sides, for making things to happen. And therefore, I want all the provosts and the deans in the house to kindly rise for recognition. Provosts and deans, thank you very much, and the Lord bless you. We have HODs, PG coordinators, and all the faculty. Time will not allow me to mention you one by one. Could you rise for recognition? Now, I want to move to those officiating this morning. I'm not going to mention those that I've introduced before. I have officiating with us today the one who we call the special song, the 2016 Stallion graduating class president, Mr. community here. We have a president who has provided an enabling environment for us to thrive. Join me in welcoming Pastor Sunday Musaya, who is going to be in charge of the offering. Okay. Also, we have here the class sponsor for this graduating class, Dr. Ititi Michael Adam. And now,
those who mentored me, I never knew I will be on this seat. But as providence we have it, I had the unique opportunity of being under the training of these two people. And I want to thank God and to thank them for their leadership. As soon as myself and my family came back to this country in 1999, Babcock was chartered. And the one whom I worked directly with as the pioneer director of academic planning way back 17 years ago is no other than the immediate past vice chancellor of Babcock University, Pastor Professor. Call to the presidency, also to serve as a pioneer staff, as the special assistant to the then vice chancellor, the position we call now chief of staff. I want to thank God for the fatherly love, the care, the mentoring over those years. Join me in welcoming the pioneer vice chancellor of Babcock University, Pastor. With the Stallion graduating class and the Royal graduating class of today. My name is Ademola Ayo. Thank you very much. God bless you.
Babcock. Sowing in the morning, sowing seeds of kindness, sowing in the sunshine, sowing in the shadows. We want to rise up and raise our voices to the Most High God as we celebrate both the Stallion and the Royals. We will all join together to sing the first stanza of our hymn of worship, which is number 369 in the SAH. It's only the graduating class members that will sing the second stanza, and then we'll join them together to sing the last stanza. Sowing seeds of kindness, and I will be here to make sure that it's done exactly as it should be. Bringing in the sheaves, we shall come rejoicing, bringing in the sheaves.
Shall we all rise for the opening prayer? Opening song, pardon me.
bow our heads and pray to God. Heavenly Father, our God and our Creator, you are the King of Kings. You are the Lord of all Lords. You are the maker of everything that exists, especially the Lord and the God of the Sabbath. Father, this moment your sons and your daughters are standing before you to worship you. We thank you for your mercies. We thank you for your love. We thank you for your grace on us. For the privilege of gathering today to witness another blessing of yours on your sons and daughters who've been in this school for 4 or 5 years, and on different families that are represented here. Father, we thank you. Lord, we thank you for the protection you granted every one of us, especially the journey mercies granted us from all our places to this very Babcock University as a venue for this celebration. Father, we thank you for life. We thank you for good health. We thank you for the providence that you gave to your children all these years they've stayed here. Lord, at this hour, we stand to celebrate. We stand to thank you. We stand to exalt your name. For all the good things you've done for us, Lord, we say, may your name be exalted and forever in Jesus' name. Dear Lord, this hour will leave to your children, your sons and daughters, the Stallion graduating class of 2016 to you. We thank you, Father, for having kept them here all these years, for giving them the wisdom and understanding to go through their studies, and Father, for a special day like tomorrow, when they will be crowned. Father, on their behalf, we glorify your name. Amen. Lord, as they leave this school any moment after their celebrations tomorrow, into the labor market and into the wider society, we hand them over to you. As you protect them here, Lord, please protect them out there. Amen. Help them, Lord, to make good use of all that they learned here, and also to continue working with you anywhere they may find themselves. Father, we pray that they will be useful to the society, to their families, to themselves, and to the church. Dear Lord, we thank you that you kept them safe here and protected them. We pray that none of them, as they move around to do their little contributions in this world, will die untimely. Amen. Dear Lord, we want to thank you for the parents that you helped to assist these ones. Father, we pray that as they have invested in these, their children, that also, Lord, you will keep them alive to witness more blessings and to reap the fruit of their labor. Amen. Father, we also pray to thank you for the teachers who are the instruments you use in preparing these ones. They have other students to take care of and also to teach. Lord, as you use them to prepare these ones for yourself and the society and humanity, also continue to use the teachers of this institution to prepare more human beings for your services. Dear Lord, we pray for Babcock University. Lord, we know there may be challenges sometime in some places, but you are greater than any challenge. This school is yours. Father, continue as we pray to take the school from height to higher heights. Amen. Dear Lord, we thank you for every family represented here. The Lord, they shall be giving testimonies of the blessings you've given them by allowing their children and words to pass through the school. Especially this hour, we present the speaker, the instrument he will use to bless us. Father, please speak to us through him. And may we all benefit of the message of this hour. And that what we hear, Lord, this hour will encourage everyone here, bless every soul here, and prepare us for that great day that we all are waiting for. Thank you, Father, for hearing us. Thank you for blessing us. Thank you for being present in this worship. We pray in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen.
Happy Sabbath, children of God. Happy Sabbath, children of God. In the spirit of worship, I want to start by saying, great stallions, great stallions. May the Lord continue to bless us all in Jesus' name. As we sit in worship, let's call on the Stallion graduating class choir to give us a special song. Let's make them welcome.
Morning, everybody, once again. Good morning, everybody, once again. Okay, so we're just thanking God this morning. We're appreciating God for life and for bringing us thus far. So the songs that we're singing this morning are very, very simple songs. Everybody knows the song. So join us this morning as we're going to worship God and thank God. Thank you.
Ibu cukup ibu gimana?
Much. May the Lord continue to be with you. I stand at this moment to praise God, appreciate God for the success we are celebrating at this moment. On behalf of the Stallion graduating class, the Royal graduating class, may the Lord continue to be with you. This is the Lord's doing. It is what? Marvelous in our sight. And with this, let's bring out our offering to praise God, to appreciate Him for what He has done for us. It is He that has begun with us. It is He that has taken us to this far. Praise be the name of the Lord. Praise be the name of the Lord. At this time, I will invite the evangelists to give us special song as we bring out our offering unto the Lord to say, thank you, Baba, for what you have done for us. Thank you.
Amen. Amen.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
living life begins because a baby fights for freedom. And songs we love our freedom theme. Some have walked through fire and sword to find a way to freedom, and some face hell itself.
Thank you very much. Let's stand up as we pray. Father in heaven, at this moment, we are saying thank you for all that you have done for us. Thank you for the gift of life. Thank you for your children that are graduating. Father, thank you for the way you have begun with them. Thank you for the success that have been achieved. Glory be unto your holy name. Father, this is our offering. Kindly accept it, O Lord. Accept us as living sacrifice unto you. Father, bless our hands. As these are going into the labor market, Father, go with them. Make them to be great instruments in your hand. Father, bless their hand. Make them to be source of blessings to the world. Thank you, Father, for answering our prayers. Thank you for your grace that is sufficient for us. Thank you for the gift of eternal life. Praise be unto your name. In Jesus' name we have prayed. Amen.
It's time for Bible reading, and I hope the choristers have their Bibles, because everyone has to participate in this Bible reading. Place this text for today. The Bible reading for today is specially, very specially selected for those of us graduating today. These are words of assurance, words to confirm the promises of the Lord upon your lives. So may I at this point invite you to the book of Deuteronomy. Deuteronomy chapter 32. We're reading two verses, verses 11 and 12. Are we there? If you have your Bibles, please open to that book of the Bible and the chapter and the two verses. If you have your e-devices, I also invite you to make good use of them at this point. I am believing this reading will bring assurance to your life. Deuteronomy chapter 32, I am reading from the King James Version. Deuteronomy 32, beginning at verse 11 through verse 12, I read, "As an eagle stirs up its nest, hovers over its young, spreading out its wings, taking them up, carrying them on its wings. This is the prayer. Verse 12. So the Lord alone led him, and there was no foreign God with him. I pray the Lord will bless today the reading, the hearing, and the doing of his word. In Jesus' name.
Before the choir we present their song, I want to say I plead guilty as charged. The women folk in the house said, Pastor Tayo, you did not introduce your wife. And I plead guilty. I have in the house my wife of 22 years. Just 2 days ago, and she has been a very, very good friend, a prayer warrior. Thank you very much, Oluwatoyin Tayo. Could you stand for recognition? All right, now I want to introduce the one whom God has chosen to be the oracle of God for this hour. The speaker of today is not only a friend, but a spiritual advisor to me. Someone whom God has used in diverse ways. Our preacher of this hour is one of the deputy pro-chancellor of Babcock University, and is currently serving as the president of Northern Nigerian Union Conference. He is married, blessed with children and grandchildren. As a matter of fact, the children also passed through Babcock University. He has served the church in various capacities as a district pastor, hospital chaplain, conference evangelist, conference secretary, and currently the president of the North Nigerian Union Conference. He has been in ministry for the past 26 years after having served in Ahmadu Bello University for 10 years, thus making a total of 36 years altogether in the service to our fatherland. Join me in welcoming to the podium after the choir, Pastor Dr. Francis Freemia Daria. Thank you very much.
Still in the mood of worship, I would want us to sit back and relax as we listen to the Babcock University Choir. God bless you.
God, man. God bless God for me, man. What a peaceful atmosphere. Just give honor and glory to God. Let's say amen to that. That is
a saying that goes this way, that experience is the best what? Best teacher. I am standing here to appreciate God and to appreciate the leadership of Babcock University for this opportunity granted to me to stand before God's people. Such opportunities are always very rare. And so, when it comes, we have to appreciate it. I have seated at the front of me here leaders that the Lord has used to make me be what I am, that today I can stand before you. And I want to appreciate them too. I remember 1992, when I came, I have time, man, let me share my experience. Oh, yeah. Amen. It wasn't easy. When I came here at an old age to study, to get a degree in theology, 1992, I was already at the age of about 40. And so I left my family back in the village, and I came and I spent only but 3 months. After the 3 months, I didn't write the exam, I didn't write the final exam for that quarter. So I had to go back. I remember that 9 o'clock in the morning, when Professor Mackinday, probably had forgotten, he saw me standing with my box at the entrance of the university. And they said, boy, where are you going? I told him I was going home. And he said, don't worry, let me pick you. I'm going to Lagos. I will pick you. Go home, we'll be praying for you. And he took me. And I left the university. I don't know, he was really praying for me. I spent another 6 years before that prayer was answered. And I came again. And Pastor Mackinday saw me. And he said, are you ready? I said, yes. Where's your family? I said, I don't come with them. He said, no, you must bring them. And he worked it out for me. And I brought my wife. And by my number of children, you may like to know. It was a Sabbath school class. You know? Just a family equal to that of Noah in the Bible. Yes. Myself, my wife, and how many children? 6 of them. So we were 8, and we came to Aswa. Glory be to God. It wasn't easy. But I want to thank God because, sincerely speaking, it was through that time, prayer, prof, that I came back to Aswa. And my children were able to go to school. 2 of them have graduated. 1 is graduating next year from this school. And by the special grace of God, our last born will be graduating from Babcock University. We need to give God the glory.
I remembered again when the first time a computer was bought, a desktop computer was bought for us at the Pioneer Church. And Professor Lalede was to commission it. You see, I am sharing this experience with you so that you know how life has been with me and maybe unto all of us. And so he stood and he said, Pastors, because he was addressing us, he said, Pastors, I am an illiterate to the computer. But you pay attention. Pay attention. I still remember it. I put it in my brain. But truth is that only few of us took him serious. Few of us took him serious. I was one of those who didn't take him serious. But it backfired one day. When I had the opportunity to go and do my doctorate program in Andrews University, our first class was a shameful time for me. Because we were 19 in the class. All the 18, everybody had a laptop. Yes, professor was lecturing and I was just saying, but I had bought side books, long notch. Oh yeah, man, I need to tell you, man. Yes. Because it is time for me to tell you, to share my experience with you. Even after this, if the time is off, we'll pray and go. Professor Patterson was lecturing that day, and I hid myself at the back and I was writing. And he came, he saw me, he said, my friend, what are you doing here? I said, I'm a student. He said, he went back and checked the list. And then because he asked me of my name, I said, I'm a pastor, Pastor Daria. He said, okay, don't worry. He went and checked the list and he saw my name there. He came back and then he tapped me and said, tomorrow, don't come back to this class. Unless you are ready to come with a laptop computer. Don't come back to the class. I'm just telling you life stories. If I had listened to Professor Lalade, okay, I wouldn't have been put to such a shameful situation. That night, I had to order for a laptop computer online. By 10 p.m., I had it. You know, I didn't even see the person who brought it. They dropped it out there in the night. Somebody who helped me to order for it, said, just check around 12 o'clock. Just open your door, you see it. And I saw it. After some few months, Professor Lalade came again. I don't know what brought him to Andrews. And I was deeply involved in the work study because I sponsored myself. I was not sponsorship from my conference or union. I left on my own. And so Professor Lalade was passing by and I sighted him. I was inside the kitchen doing scrubbing of those big pots. The big ones, you know, that you cannot put your hand, it will not, unless your head will enter inside. Yes. When I sighted him, I quickly went into that pot because I didn't want him to see me. Not knowing that he has seen me earlier than the time I went inside the pot. Yeah, man. It happened. For those of us who wish to go and study in America, I don't want to discourage you, but I pray the Lord will help you there. Yeah, man. When Prof had eaten his meal, he went through the other side because he knows the in and out of that cafeteria. So, yeah, listen, you are faster than me, man. You are faster than me. He came, and when I saw him again passing, I entered the port. He came around, then he tapped me. He said, Pastor. I said, I'm in trouble. And he said, another way to encourage me, he said, don't worry. When I was doing my program in Nandos, I also work in this kitchen. He said, I also did the same work like you are doing now. And that served as an encouragement to me. I said, really? He said, yes. He said, please, just do your studies. And by the time you succeed, you go back home to serve. Yeah. And I said, thank you. So I need to appreciate them, my people. God can always use people to do what? To encourage you. Listen to the words of elders. Please. My note, you see, I wanted to bring a note that Uncle Joe gave me when I was going to study. It is still there alive. Except that I didn't come direct from home. It's inside my Bible. When I was going and I branched his office when he was still the union president so that he could pray for me, and he did. And then not only that, he said, Pastor, let me write down this. And then he wrote the list about 7 items. I can remember 2. He said, please, when you get to America, remain focused. Know that you are a pastor. Don't forget that you are what? You are a pastor. Remain focused so that you finish your program. We need you back. Come and serve. He wrote it down. He didn't just tell me verbally. He wrote it down. I still have that paper. Then one other thing he mentioned among the 7, he said, please, when you go to America, avoid credit card. Uncle Joe, am I speaking? Oh, yeah, man. He said, avoid, try as much as possible. Never don't engage yourself in don't do it. And I thank him because I didn't know. I saw people borrowing money. Using when you enter the store to do some shopping. Whether you have money in the bank or not, you can shop in America. Huh? Oh, man, the men will carry that basket pushing. Yeah? Then your wife will be following you. You are the one, you become the servant, unlike in Africa. That is your wife who is holding it, and then you are following. But over there is the man. So your wife will be the one picking whatever she wants to pick, man. And then you are pushing it, and then she's dropping it there. Whether you have money or not, that is what we call credit. You just use your credit card, just swap at the computer, this and that. You pay you on credit. People are living on credits in America. Many people. Yes, many. And that's where some of us, man, would like to go. Some of us that have had the opportunity to be there, we can tell you the story. I may not mention all of you here, man. I know Mrs. Magaji also served as a source of encouragement to me. I don't know whether she's around. I want to say this, if she's Mrs. Magaji, not here. Yeah. Shem Magaji, man. When I was leaving, she said, Pastor, that was the time I was getting discouraged. She said, Pastor, if you leave this campus for any reason, you will regret it one day. said, don't go anywhere. Stay and study in Nashua. And I also kept that. I registered in my brain, man, and I made use of it. Thank you, sister. But I'll say to my colleagues that we're in the office now, we have three union presidents in Nigeria. Pastor Dr. Wolabi, Pastor Dr. Udo. We work as twins, even though we're three. Maybe we call them triplets, although I'm much more older than them. Yes, man. I wish I had had the opportunity to work with these young people. I wish, but anyway, God's time is the best. They've taught me so many things, but I'll mention one. You know, one of the books that Ben Carson had written or authored is titled Think Big. Is that not so? How many of us have read that book? Think Big. Oh, student, you need to buy and read of Think Big. Yes. Think big. They have taught me that lesson, that I should always think big. And I've started it, although I have very few years. But I'll make use of that for the next few years that I have to serve. Amen? Let us pray. A kind and gracious Father in heaven, the time has come for you to speak to this congregation through me. I know, Father, that you have a message for these two graduating classes. Please, Father, use me as an instrument to bless somebody. May we, Father, listen to you while you speak to us. Thank you because you do this favor. We ask in Jesus' name. Amen. Do not be long, man. Need to break it down, man. Oh, yeah. You take your Bibles in your hands again. Okay. As we see the topic for our discussion this morning, growing through transitions and what? Trials. Growing through transitions and trials. And God, through Moses, in the book of Deuteronomy chapter 32, where my brother read, 32 verses 11 and 12, says, as an eagle tears up its nest, hovers over its young, spreading out its wings and taking them up, carrying them on its wings. So the Lord alone led him, and there was no foreign God with him. Amen. What is a nest? A nest is a blessing from God. I'm sure the young people graduating today, you've seen a nest somewhere. Have you ever seen a nest? Let me see. I don't know. I'm not talking of the elderly ones. Huh? The nest of a bird. Let me wave your hand so that I know that I'm speaking with people, man. All right, you've seen a nest. Okay, let me give a brief description of what a nest is all about. So a nest is a blessing from God. A nest, being living in a nest means that you belong to somebody who is greater, who cares about you. Somebody that is greater than you. And he has much concern about you. He loves you. He cares for you. He gives protection unto you. You belong to somebody. It is a place where you are wanted. That is a nest. A place of comfort. A nest is a place of comfort because the young ones, the inhabitants of a nest, they feel secured. They know that somebody cares. Somebody is protecting them. And so they are comfortable. All of us, at one time or the other, had, you know, lived in a nest. You may not be aware of it, but it is true. A nest is a great experience because its youthful inhabitants aren't yet wise enough to see God's ways. God gives us the eagle story in Deuteronomy chapter 32, verses 11 to 12, to help us remember the ways he works with all of us, including our graduates today, both sides. We have a graduate, and then we have the what? The undergraduate. Let's begin at the eagle's nest to explain why God steers your nest. An eagle's nest can be up to, sometimes for those who study the lives of birds, an eagle's nest could be as deep as 20 feet, maybe the length of about maybe 4 tallest people in the world. About 4. Very wide. And with a width of 9.5 feet. Some nests are strong enough to hold an adult human being. That is true of an eagle's nest. And so pairs of eagles build their nest high in a tall tree away from danger. It is difficult for you or for one to sight the nest of an eagle because they go to where there is a very thick forest and find the highest, the tallest tree, and then they build a nest there. It is not easy to sight it. And you may make an attempt, may try it, and see if you can find one. So they use sticks, branches, and bones to create the nest and then cover it with leaves, fur, and other stuffed materials to create an area to cradle their eggs. So the base of the nest is built with what? Dry sticks and with dry bones that the bird pick somewhere to build, you know, the bottom, the base. And then this is overlaid with leaves or any soft material preparing for the eaglets. And so when the eggs are laid, after some times, when they are hatched, the eaglets are covered. When you read the story, they are covered for good 30 days. And how did they receive their nourishment? The male eagle brings food 8 times in a day to feed the mother eagle and the children, or the eaglets, you may call them. 8 times. And so the eaglets, you know, feel, you know, comfortable. They have been fed. And they grow to be very heavy. To the extent that they will not be able to fly because they are plumbing. See them heavy. They have been fed in a comfortable zone. The next. And they think sometimes, what? It is better we remain in this condition. Let us be here in this manner so that our parents will continue to give us food. Oh, yeah, man. But then, the parents are wise. They know what is best. The parents or the eagles cannot control to feed the eaglets in that manner. They must learn how to take care of themselves. My young people, you have reached a stage now that you may not continue to depend on your parents. Somebody made a statement here and he said, you will soon go to the labor market. That is true. It is one thing to graduate. It's another thing to do what? Yeah, to serve, to struggle for survival. No wonder some people call this, BA, they said, it is beginning again. So you are somewhere in the middle of life. That's what I want you to take note of. You are just in the middle. You've reached the stage of the eaglet that you need to begin another life altogether. Your parents will not continue to give you food. I'm no more giving food to my children that graduated from Babcock. Instead, they help me with my grandchildren. Oh, yeah. You know, their sense of, hey, man, say, daddy, take this, take that. And I said, may God bless you. So soon, man, you will soon go into the labor market. And we need to pray for you. Back to the eaglets. The eaglets feel they should not be disturbed. But the parent eagles must teach them how to depend on their on themselves. So how do they do it? The parent eagles will begin to remove the soft materials, the leaves that were built on top of the thorny stones and bones. Gradually removing them until every soft material is taken out. And at that time, the eaglets begin to suffer. They have no place of comfort again. They cannot sleep well. And they are wondering what is going on with our parents. They built a nest, a beautiful place for us, and now they are scattering it again. Where do they want us to go? But the parent eagles have what? A plan. They want the eaglets to be on their own. The male eagle cannot continue to supply food for the eaglet. But until when? So they have to teach the eaglets to find food for themselves. And so, the story says that by the time the eaglets have no place again to settle, no place of comfort in the nest, they are forced to rise up, try to, fly to, the top of the nest. When they look at the ground far away from them, they are afraid. But the male eagle brings food and try to entice them to come with the food as it wants to give to them to just fly away. And so They remain, some of them are just on the top. No food, hunger. They have nothing to eat. And therefore, one day, they must take the risk. The male eagle will bring food and keep it very close, just on the ground or on another tree close by the tallest tree there. And then they are taught to move. Okay? They make the attempt to fly. And then they discover that when they make the attempt, they always succeed. Amen? Hey, success in this life. In this life, you must work hard. You must struggle. Otherwise, you may not reach where God intends that you should be. You can be your enemy. You can be your, you can create an enmity within you. You can stand against your progress. Why did God use this story of eagles? What is the lesson that we should learn from it? He led the children of Israel out of the house of what? Bondage. You know the story? He led them by day through what? Cloud cover. And at night, Pillar of fire. I don't know my graduating class or classes. How much appreciation that you have shown to your parents all these days, even before you came to Babcock, and within the years of your study in Babcock, your sponsors, you need to appreciate them. So it was as a result of this that when the children of Israel now finally arrived the promised land, that God put a song into the heart of Moses. And Moses sang this. And then he used this metaphor of an eagle and said, "Hey God, I know that you are the one that has taken care of us." When Abraham was called, and with a promise, God said, "You leave your country to a land that flows with what? Milk and honey." That was a promise. And Abraham believed God. Abraham believed God, and then he left his country. And God really took him to the promised land, where there was milk and what? And honey. And that was the comfort zone. We want to look at that as the land of Canaan, as a nest. Abraham had no problem with his family. But until a time came that God had to ask them to move. He said, "Hey, look, this life, if you are left in a comfort zone for as long as you live in this world, you may not learn how to trust God." Hunger came. There was a famine in the land of Canaan. So the children of Abraham, Jacob, and Esau, and their grandchildren, they were forced to do what? To leave the land of Canaan to where? To Egypt. One comfort zone, you move to a difficult zone, and you go to another comfort zone, you move to another difficult zone. That is how life's supposed to be. Balance off. And so they went to, after they've suffered the hunger in the land of Canaan, they were taken to Egypt through Joseph. You know the story of Joseph?
Of Israel. He himself didn't know that God was preparing him to be
an assistant to the children of or to his brothers. But he had to do it in a hard way. You know the story. And eventually God said, okay, the best part of Egypt was given to them. That's the land of what? Goshen. Goshen was the best part of Egypt. And maybe, I don't know, I've not been to Egypt. Some of you probably have been there. It's like Goshen is very close to, you know, it's a coastland, very close to the Nile. Nile River. I don't know, I've not been there. But I still remember that in those days, when we were in secondary school, and for those of us who did geography, there used to be a question like this. They said, no Nile, no Egypt, discuss. I don't know. To somebody, yeah. They said, no Nile, no Egypt, and said, discuss. You know, this said they are very clever. No Nile, no Egypt, they said, discuss. And if you know the story very well, you can write even 5 pages. Yes, but if you don't know it, you don't know it. That's the best part of Egypt. And they were there and they were comfortable. Their hope, their prayer was that they should remain in the land of Goshen for how long? Forever. Just like the eaglet in the nest. They have the feeling that they should be there and nobody to disturb them. Sometimes when we are asked to leave our comfort zone, oh man, we complain, we find it difficult. And say, why? Why? Why am I asked to leave northern Nigeria and come to go to the east? I know Professor Mionu was, he called me some weeks ago. And he said, hey, Pastor, how are you? I said, I'm fine. I will not finish the story. Because he's there. Yeah, man. So sometimes you need to leave your comfort zone and go to another area. That is life. And so the children of Israel were asked to move. Because a time came that they could not. They didn't know that God had promised them how many years? 40 years only. 400 years to live in Egypt. They were to sojourn in Egypt for 400 years, and after that, they were to move out of Egypt to go to where God had purposed that they should be. And they fell back. He said, where should we go? And then God said, okay, I know that you must go. You don't have a choice. Because I had chosen your grandfather, Abraham, and had promised it, and I must fulfill my promise. That's God's faith. And so God prays for somebody, and they look at that man as a wicked man. Another Pharaoh. You know the story? Another Pharaoh. Sometimes we give names to some of our leaders by mistake. There is no leader, let me tell you this. Not even the church, even the secular world, that is not being placed by God himself. I believe it. I don't know about you. Because my Bible says we should respect the government, true or false. So if we are asked, if the Bible asks us to respect the leaders of our world government, is it the church that we should not respect? Is it the church leaders that we should not respect? All leaders have been instituted by God. And therefore, they were asked to move. And so they were reluctant. They're going to have to use other means. Okay? They were made to suffer. No more nests again. They were making bricks. They were asked to double the quantity. Yes, and not only that, hard labor. The canes were used on them while they were doing the work. Produce more than what you used to produce in a day. Double it. And the heart is so tough. And so finally, when the time comes for God to now move them, they were ready to move. Two of us, the children of Israel were ready to move because they could not bear the hardship. They couldn't bear it. And the ten plagues came, and they were not affected. And at the end, they had to leave to where God wanted them to do. God wants you, my people, all of us seated here, to be somewhere. If we cooperate with him, young people, because some of you are going to be leaders of Nigeria. I don't know who you are, but some of you, pray that you will be the next minister. I say amen to that. Pray that you will be the next leader in the Seventh Adventist Church. Pray that you will be the next leader, you know, wherever. Could be in the world. Obama is not an, it's a black American. Maybe you could be there if you could endure the hardship. Nothing good comes what? Easy. So we must work hard. And like the song we sang, the first song, it said, bringing in what? The sheaves. You cannot bring the sheaves where you've not done your work. Yes. You must work hard in order to bring a reasonable what? Reasonable portion of the sheaves. Our prayer for you today is that the Lord will bless your effort. Amen. That your effort will never go without the blessings of God. Amen. That what you have learned in Babcock University will help you as all of us who journey to the heavenly kingdom. As one thing I saw, yes, I must tell you, because we are celebrating two things here. We are celebrating the Sabbath. We are celebrating your success. Celebrating the Sabbath, celebrating your success. So what you have learned in this institution, don't throw it away. As you leave, please package it well. If you package it well, you'll be able to help somebody else. You'll help those who are not opportune to be in Babcock. I thought they would say amen to that. You want to share what you have learned with those who didn't have the same opportunity like you. Because you are going to be exceptional leaders. So our prayer this morning is that all of us will remain faithful to the call that the Lord has given to us. So that at the end, when our work is fully done in this world, we shall all be ushered into the heavenly kingdom which the Lord has gone to prepare for us. May that be our experience in Jesus' name. But we want to pray for the young people. I want to invite Uncle Joe. I want him to pray for your children and grandchildren that are here. So I want the two classes, come on, the undergraduate and the postgraduate, to stand up. Others, you can remain sitting, because this prayer is for them only. Uncle Joe, you're welcome, sir.
Shall we all rise? All head bowed, all eyes closed, our mouth shut. The Ancient of Days. Our Heavenly Father, want to thank you for A day like this that we have been looking forward to for the past 4 or 5 years. Many began this job, began these studies with us. They couldn't make it to the end of the road. We have buried some of them, and some, due to the decision they made, they couldn't get here. But all who are standing before you this moment listened to your voice, followed your footstep, and you guided them to the end of the road. And that's why, Father, we are glorifying you today. That's why we are thanking you today. Now, as they go to the world, young eaglets, we have asked them to leave their comfort zone, where they are being protected by the rules and regulations here. Father, go with them. Open the door for them. Let them find favor in your sight and in the sight of men. Every plan and the scheming of the devil against these children of yours, Father, protect them. Provide for them. You've said in your word, those who fear you will never beg for bread. Father, bless them. May they not beg for bread. Grant them good health. Grant them long life. Or may we continue to hear good news about them. Father, may their parents never bury them. I give them into your hand when they will be choosing. This is a great step in people's life. Because whosoever you join your life with determined your destiny. So, Lord, choose for them. Amen. Those you have chosen for, may your spirit live in their homes. Amen. Once more, others may be looking for job. They may not get. But, Father, give job to your children. Amen. When they will be serving, may they not serve among Boko Harams. Amen. May you give them protection. Amen. Father, thank you for the messages of your son today, giving us an assurance that we will be carried on your wings. No arms will come around us. Father, thank you for hearing our prayers. Bless all of us together. In the mighty name of Jesus, we pray. Amen.
It is time to appreciate the speaker of the hour. If you have been blessed today, please, can you wave your hand and say a big amen?
Amen.
May I invite my dear pastor to come up? Yeah, on behalf of the and the wife, please. Because eagle cannot fly with just one wing. The eagle requires the two. Madam, please come. Please come. Yes. You want us to do there? Okay. We are directed to do it there so that everybody can see you. Thank you. Please come. So on behalf of the graduating class, the Royal, and the Stallion, the Governing Council of the University, the Vice Chancellor, the congregation, we appreciate your message of the hour. Thank you for honoring our invitation. We believe strongly if we call you again, you will come. I will invite Dr. Mrs. Aja Victoria to present a little token to symbolize our appreciation to you. Thank you.
And so we present the appreciation award for being the guest speaker for 2016 Sabbath guest speaker, in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit.
I can say that we're blessed today. The Lord has continually been our God, and He will continue to be your God in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. We must now begin to round off our programs. He said, let every lamp be burning bright. The darkest hour is nearing. We take our closing hymn from SDAH 595, hymn 595. Let every lamp be burning bright. We'll take the first, the second, and the last stanza. We'll skip the third stanza.
Let us close our eyes for the benediction. Our most loving God, the God that has been our help in the ages past, we depend on you for the years to come. Father, you have been faithful from the beginning. We celebrate your faithfulness. Father, we want to continue to trust you for the future successes. And so, Lord, at this time, I want to commit the Board of Trustees, the Governing Council, the management staff, the academic and non-academic staff, and especially today, our graduating students, the Stallions and the Royal members of the graduating class. We want to commit to you, all others that are connected with Babcock University. Please, Lord, continue to be our Lord. Amen. Continue to be our shepherd. Amen. Continue to be our teacher. Amen. Continue to be our counselor. Amen. Oh, Lord, continue to be our provider. Amen. And our protector. And more than anything else, Lord, continue to be our guide. Lord, we pray that as we depend on you, continue to reign in our individual hearts. Continue to reign in our lives. Continue to reign in our homes. Continue to reign in Babcock University. Continue to reign in your church, the Seventh-day Adventist Church. Continue to reign in Nigeria and Africa at large. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.